to do what I call infak Ramadan, yeah, sharing during Ramadan, yeah. Hopefully that this little effort will, you know, bring blessing to all of us here, inshallah, yeah. So my dear friend, what I would like to share today is simply a title, entitled Leadership 101, yeah. I think around the world, we can see that people talk about leadership even at the world stage, at our so-called national stage, or even in organization. And whatever it is, still, we found that leadership still what we call a big challenge among all of us. So I think for that, I would like to share. Of course, leadership is a huge topic. But today, within 1.5 hours given, yeah, I would like to share a concept which is so simple, yeah. But then again, the way I look at it, not many people aware about it, yeah. So this is what I would like to do today, yeah. And I hope along the way we can have some discussion here that too, so that we can learn from each other, yeah. So I think that is the what we call the reason why we have this session. Okay, for that, allow me to share my presentation today. Yeah. Okay, hold on. Okay, checking. Can everyone see the slides? Boleh nampak ke semua?
Okay, cantik.
Cantik ya. Okay, I think for that, let me just introduce myself first. Yeah, who am I? Yeah. Okay, my name is Mior Azli, Mior Maisa. You can call me Mior, yeah. So actually I'm working in Tenaga Nasional for the past almost 37 or 38 years, yeah. It's a long time. I've been very, what you call this, I didn't go anywhere, but I've been moving all over the places in Tenaga, because each division in Tenaga is just like another company, yeah, Tuan Sharif.
Yeah, betul.
So it is, and over the, I mean, for the first 20 years, I involved in engineering work. Basically, I'm an engineer by profession. Yeah, I work on transmission projects. Yeah, in design, in designing, in construction, and also in some sort of consultancy job. Yeah, for engineering. But after 20 years, I believe I need to move on. So I moved into what we call into basically management and leadership, be it on individual or in organization. Yeah. And at this moment, I'm heading what we call a unit called Strategic Leadership Training and Consultancy in Tenaga. We actually focus mainly to develop leadership among TMB people. Yeah. Okay. So in this life, one thing that that hold me, I strongly adhere to this quote. Yeah, it says that if you and I do not think beyond what has been taught, this place will not progress. I do hope that through this 1.5 hours module, yeah, we can see something different beyond our current thinking, so that we can make this place better. Better for all of us, yeah. So for this particular program, I have a caveat here, because I believe here, yeah, all of us here are all trainers, and believe also we are here are practical people. That's why when come to this sharing, yeah, I would like to say that we are here not to just explore ideas that can be shared, nor conclude that we already know them. That is not important, yeah. But what important is we are in this program because we want these ideas to assist us in implementing change, be it for ourselves or to ensure that our team achieve the desired result. So I believe this is the name of the game. So in order to achieve this so-called matter, yeah, I would like to invite especially myself, yeah, and all friends here to involve in what I call a deep learning. Yeah, when we talk about deep learning, there are 5 basic questions that we need to entertain throughout this program. Yeah, so first question is simply, do I understand what being shared? Number one. Number two, if I understand that, do you think that the idea can help me in my life or in my work? And if that's so, question number three will be, do I know how to practice this knowledge? Yeah, how to leverage knowledge in our work or in our life? And question number four is all about whether we're practicing or not. And last but not least, it is all about what lesson learned from this so-called practice. So I strongly believe, based on my own personal experience, whenever we approach certain knowledge in this manner, God willing, we can have what we call deep learning. Yeah. So it's compared to just learning the idea and then do nothing about it. Yeah. So that is the contradict to deep learning, which is I call it shallow learning. Yeah. Okay, that is what we call my mukadimah, my opening. Yeah. So that I think it sets the tone for this sharing. Yeah. So let's talk about leadership. Yeah. To quick start on this topic, yeah, I would like you guys to maybe we hear from our friends, yeah, maybe two or three people friends from here. How you define or what you know about life? Basically, what is life to you people? Okay, maybe Tuan Sharif, you would like to start first. Maybe you as my co-host, you want to ask someone ke untuk share their idea, or you yourself want to share to answer this question. By the way, my dear friend, every answer is correct. I don't care how stupid it is, it's still correct. Yeah, because that represents our background. Okay, shoot. Silakan, Tuan Syarif.
Okay, we're talking about life, you know, we have to ask the question, why we exist in this world? Why God created us?
Mm.
Yeah? Then everybody have a purpose in life, right? Mm. Everybody have a purpose in life. So let us think, why God created us?
Mm.
Is it to just makan tidur saja ke? Is it just nak kaya ke?
Mm.
Is it nak... So it is not help other people. So every people have different purpose in life. So that is one question we need to ask ourselves. Then once we know that question, then our life will be much, much more easier and smoother. That's what I think what is life is. Thank you, Tomio.
Okay, let's listen from our book Tauke. Okay, buku kita.
Danny.
Danny, can you give your point of view? What life to you? What is life to you? Wah, thinking aloud. Shoot, Danny. Please share. What do you think? Simple question, but then again, it really need a deep thought, yeah, Danny?
Unmute, Danny. You're muted, Danny. You're muted. Okay, sorry about that. Important thing is, to me, it's a journey of searching the meaning in your life. Life to me is a searching, the journey of searching.
Okay.
Along the way, you might like it, you might have a joy, you might have a happy, you might have sorrow, all the thing is there. Mm. Mm. So this is, to me, is a meaning. So everything is come, you might treasure it. And if you know how to maneuver it, then You get it. If you against it, then I'm so sorry that you're still suffering. You're still not doing what is right. This is, to me, it's a life. So it's unknown to me, but it's a journey for me to search. That's all.
Okay. Thank you, Danny. Maybe you would like to ask from the youngest person here. Is that you, Patricia? Maybe we want to hear from what the young people have to say about what is life. Okay, mind sharing?
Yeah, can. Thanks, Samuel. First, it's a privilege of being the young one, right? Okay, for me, life is like, I condone, very agree with Mr. Sharif said, this life is, what is your, God created you is for what? Like, and then when you said about life is, it's too broad, because for me, life is like, you are created in this world not to be alone, and you are not to be like just sitting there. Because now what I see is like, I saw a lot of people have this individualism or private things more now. So we don't talk to others, or we just see others from online or what, but often we like talking face to face is very, 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 how to say now, it's very, very hard now because we have our social media in. So when we're talking in social media, we really not understand how about others people real life. I mean, in their shoes, like, do we see them like, oh, I see them is like that, and then why am I not achieving the same result or same achievement as them? So we compare each other's life like in the same level, but in fact it's not. So for me, life is very different. From which point that you stood, I can say it's six now. I say six, but at your point of view, maybe it's nine or some other value. So that's the meaning of life for me. We see different things on different people, but we don't know in actual what really happened to them.
Okay, thank you, Patricia. Yeah. Okay, why not we listen last but not least from Martin, since he's from Europe, now he resides in Malaysia. Maybe, for people like Martin, maybe he has a very unique perspective towards life. Martin, you don't mind sharing?
Very simple philosophy.
Yes.
Eat, sleep, repeat.
Okay, good one.
Practical, very practical.
That's a German perspective for you.
No, that's why I had to run away from Germany, because they are working too much. They don't enjoy life. No, just kidding.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, okay.
We have somebody from chat. Okay, let me read it out.
Okay.
Sure. Gina says, life is about being in service to others and at the same time finding joy and still trying.
Okay,
that's from Gina. Another one from Olivia Chan. Life in me is with feeling, love, sad, and dream.
Wow.
Okay. All right.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. I think we have heard several perspectives about life from our friends here. It's very funny. Yeah? Whenever I conduct this kind of classes, whenever I ask this question, if I ask 10 people,
10 different.
I get 10 different perspectives.
Yeah.
To me, no one is wrong. Yeah, because who am I to say they are wrong? Because everyone entitled for their perspective. Yeah, but then again, it shows to me that everyone have different perspective, and because of that, sometimes it creates some kind of problems among us. Yeah, so this is something for us to ponder. Of course, to talk about this, it will take 3 days, 3 nights. Yeah, Tuan Sharif. Yeah,
so
I just want to just to stop here, and then why don't we ponder upon what I have to share here based on this program? Yeah. Okay, according to this program, what is life? Is to make it what I call simpler. Yeah, life is all about this. Let me share you a story. Okay, for that matter, this is what I call planet Earth. I believe everyone agree with me on that. Yeah, and this is where we live. This is our world. I never heard any human being living outside this planet Earth. Yeah, I don't know Elon Musk is very serious about going to Mars. That is this beside the story. But whatever I know, prior to this, all of us are here. Yeah. So having said this, if I may look what we call a life of a person. Yeah. If you look at it carefully, it starts somewhere. Let's say here, on the left hand side dot. This is I call DOB. Date of birth, yeah, and in this life, that this particular person will go through a journey until he or she ends at on the right hand side. I call it DOD. This is date of death, yeah. And whatever it is, our life, even when we are in this program, we are between these two dots. We are moving closely to the right, not moving to the left, yeah? But somehow or other, life is not that simple. There are ups and downs in this life, yeah? Whatever on top of the white line is, I call it when we have ease, whereas below the white line, I call that time when we have difficulty. So the way I look at it, life is a series of ups and downs. And this is what people nowadays call VUCA. Yeah? Volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity. So, and the interesting question based on the response from you guys just now, somehow or other, we can relate to this diagram. Again, different people, different perspective, different background, but somehow or other, we can relate to this diagram. And that's the reason why sometimes people look life as an adventure. Yeah. Again, there are many people look life as as a prisoner or maybe makan angin saja. Yeah. But then again, whatever it is, if you really want to really get full of from this life, life should be an adventure. But the question is, when we look at life as an adventure, obviously, as an adventurer, we need a clear goal, a clear destination. What we want to do with this so-called adventure, or rather this life. Here, being a Muslim, I believe everyone entitled to their own belief. Being a Muslim, the way I look at it, based on what I see here, life is all about getting God's blessing. Because at the end of the day, God's blessing will be the passport for us to live happily in the so-called hereafter. If you get the passport, God willing, you go to heaven. If you don't get the passport, na'uzubillah, we will, hopefully, we are not going here. Yeah. So this is life in totality. So based on this so-called, this is what this program describe what is life. So again, my dear friend, I just hope that you can compare whatever your perspective just now to whatever on the slide. And I believe, my dear friends, we have a better perspective on life. Okay, if you need to discuss further, we can always PM me to P, PM me, and we can talk more on that. But then let's move on. Based on this, what are the so-called questions that we need to ask ourselves? If you ask me, it's all about how to make this so-called adventure really worthwhile. Yeah, I can see that based on some feedback just now, we can see that people have different background, and I believe different goals that they want to achieve in this goal, in this life. Yeah. So to answer this question, this program, we suggest that in order to have this so-called life worthwhile, we should start by what I call developing our leadership capability. Yeah, why so? This will be our discussion today. But before that, before we talk further on this leadership, I think let's go into the basic. What's the basic? Basic is basically what is leadership. Again, my dear friend, why not? I think in the chat box. I think before we ask a few old friends here to give their so-called definition or their perspective, maybe you can, I give you about 1 to 2 minutes for you to type in the chat box your definition of leadership. My dear friend, once you finish, please don't press the enter button until I ask you to do so. The reason why, simply because I don't want you to be influenced by other people punya apa ni, people's response. So after 2 minutes, I said enter the button, then only you enter. So after that, I will allow my dear friend Tuan Sharif to read through some of the so-called definition. Okay, let's give ourselves about 2 minutes to type in at chat box, in the chat box, your definition of leadership. 2 minutes from now. Okay, silakan. What is leadership? Yeah. This is one particular topic being, it seems to me that all over the world require a so-called a good leadership. But until now, we can see a lot of problems here and there. All due of so-called bad leadership. Yeah. So I think to start this so-called discussion, I strongly believe all of us need to go back to the very basic by defining what is leadership. I believe everyone has different perspective on leadership, and that's where we want to learn from everyone. Yeah? Okay. Take your time. You still have about 1 minute to go. Okay, 2 minutes. Yeah, I already arrived to 2 minutes. Why don't we enter our enter button? Okay, Tuan Sharif, maybe right. You can do some of our. Wow, there's a lot.
Too many.
Okay, Tuan Sharif, why don't you read through?
Okay, I read mine first. Eh?
Yeah.
To me, leadership is the ability to effectively lead his or her follower, have the right mindset to link the organization, if it is an organization, to link the company direction, the mission, vision, shared value, into initiatives. The ability, because he can't do it alone, leadership, they need to have the ability to engage people to achieve that mission and vision. And at the end of the day, they need to deliver result. This to me is what is meant by leadership. Okay, let me read the others. Dr. Jim Sia says that leadership inspire people, work together with your workers and role model to your workers.
Okay. Good.
Another namesake, Sharif Yassin, says the ability to guide and influence others, other people to achieve goal.
Okay.
Amir Jumaat, charting, creating, facilitating path of value. Wow, this is very philosophical. to other, to pass through. Okay, I'm not sure what he meant by pass through. Okay. Zul Ibrahim, central point, anchoring factor. Very short, sweet and simple. Olivia, directorship, control, rule, power, mastery. Nick Muhammad Faris, share value, walk the talk, building people to better life. Martin, leadership is the empowerment of others without having a title. Okay, that's good. Shaira, leadership, the ability to lead a group of people to achieve the same objective and effectively. Gina, to bring people to where they want to go. Azman, the art of managing people to achieve targeted goals. Patricia, leadership is compassion and example. Danny, making things happen. Okay, that's all.
Okay, Tuan Sharif, maybe we ask a few of our friends here also. Yeah, based on those so-called input from all of us here, yeah, what we can tell from those so-called the whole definition, Tuan Sharif, what is your conclusion here based on those answers given?
Okay, when I look at the answers given, you know, it seems that everybody have that similar, even a different concept of leadership, but they have the similar line where, you know, everybody wants to have a goal, achieve that particular goal. That is what I think is common denomination in the perception of leadership among the group.
Okay, interesting. Maybe we'd like to hear from Cik Azman kita. Cik Azman, what is your point of view based on answers given by our colleague here? What it tells you?
All right, thank you. So I would say that from the response given, we can see something common. Leadership is about getting things done. You know, setting example, and what you call, I quite like what Martin mentioned, without the title, you can, inspiring people is the words. Inspiring, become a role model to achieve the goals.
It's an art.
Jasmine, yeah. Just curious. I just want to ask you a question. Yeah?
Sure.
Based on this definition or perspective on leadership, yeah, do you see, because all this is sounds positive, right? Yeah. All
right.
So do you see that this is the element that missing in whatever leadership that we see now in the market, either at world, at the international level, national level, organizational or whatever, it is something that missing in those so-called leadership. What's your point of view here, Chairman?
Okay. Practically, there are a lot of things are missing. For example, the emotional intelligence parts are the main one that missing nowadays in the leadership. You know, the empathy is not there. So I think people are more, you know, depend on the leadership style that they choose. But that are the missing part that I would say that I can see.
Okay. Maybe Danny would like to give your point of view based on the feedback. What is your takeaway here?
I cannot comment much on that, sir, because I'm not expert on leadership, but sir, I apply leadership to get things done. And there's a certain principle inside to getting done, a lot of principle. But the first thing is gaining the trust to me. Okay. I am not expert on that, but I like to practice a lot of things and try new things and try an error and to get trust, to gain trust from others, I think leadership is number one objective. This is what I learned from that simple thing.
Okay. Thank you. Maybe we'd like to hear from Tuan Sharif Yassin kita. Tuan Sharif, maybe you would like to give your point of view. What is your takeaway from feedback given on what is leadership?
Yes, I think we have to be able to differentiate leadership and being a manager. A manager and also a leader. Many people can be a manager but cannot be a leader. Because many things, sometimes we think that just get things done is a good leader. But I think it's not true, because many people can get things done, giving instructions and all that, whatever means they take, but it's not a good leader. To me, leader, it has to be very positive. He's able to motivate other people and guide other people to achieve whatever goals they try to achieve. I think that is a leadership to me.
Okay. Thank you, Tuan Sharif. Terima kasih. Yeah. Okay. We have different view on this matter, right? But if you ask me personally, based on this so-called definition given, yeah, one thing dawned on me, yeah, if you talk about developing leadership among us, if we have different definition on leadership, obviously it will create chaos. This is what I observe when I, when I do my work in Tenaga. Yeah? As you know that I'm in the area of leadership development. And one of the root cause that we observe, why is it so difficult to develop leadership? Because it seems to, based on the data, because people have different perspective on leadership. We don't have a common definition. Yeah, because at the end of the day, it is about developing leadership. It's no point talking about leadership and we go nowhere. Yeah. So I think for this particular session, yeah, I would like to share a concept where we utilize this concept or rather this definition on how to develop leadership objectively. Objectively, I underline it because that is very important, because people want the result at the end of the day. It's not just talking day and night. Yeah. So allow me to share a definition, on this leadership. And I just hope that please ponder, yeah, whatever definition that you have on leadership, please you compare to this definition and see what we learn, what we can learn from here. So this is what I would like to do onwards. Yeah. Okay, let me define leadership according to this program. Okay. If you look people around us, no matter who we are, as long we are human, yeah, we are up to something and we want to achieve something. In other words, we want to we want to develop result. Yeah, we want to get the result. Yeah. So I give you an example. Let me give an example here. Yeah. If you look at this slide, yeah, any human, no matter who they are, in this life, we have a goal. Just think about that for a moment. Yeah. And obviously, for that particular goal, that goal could be a project, could be initiative, it could be anything. Yeah. And obviously, it won't have a good result. So that's us. If you look at all of us, this is us. Yeah. And whatever, in order to achieve result, obviously, we need to what we call identify or list out what are the activities that we need to do in order to turn goal into result. So I give you an example. Yeah. Just an example. Let's say we have one example, one particular person, my dear friend, to deliver project XYZ within time, cost, and quality. That is one particular goal. And obviously, this gentleman or this lady would like to achieve what we call to deliver project XYZ within time, cost, and quality. So that's the name of the game. In between these two things, we have to have a series of activities in order to realize the goal. Example, this could be part of the so-called initiative that he need to do. So if you look carefully, this is this activity, we can divide into three main so-called cluster. Yeah, this so-called activity, in order to realize the goal, we can divide it into three main cluster. Yeah, so what are those cluster? Yeah. Okay, group number one is what I call planning the future. I think if you look at our own work, yeah, no matter what we are doing, if you look back what we have done before, yeah, this has happened to us. Secondly, is about care to engage. Cik Azman tadi cakap pasal emotional kind of thing, yeah, Cik Azman. So basically, when it comes to emotional, basically is, are you care to engage? This is have to got to do with your so-called your emotional. In many cases, future, I go back to future, it got to do a lot with your intellectual. Yeah. And then when come to what we call to the last cluster or last group, it is what we call commit to deliver. This basically is on your action. Yeah. So in other words, for whatever activity that we do, there are three main group activities. First, plan the future, care to engage, and last but not least, commit to deliver. Tuan Aziz Azman, Tuan Azman, ada komen tak tentang apa yang nampak kat sini? What is your comment? Is it make sense to you ataupun you have other idea here?
This is very solid. I like the three category that you put. It's consolidated. And yeah, I'm impressed with this. The plan, the future, care to engage, commit to deliver. That's the keywords. Perfect.
Cik Azman, if you don't mind, I engage with you with some discussion. Yeah.
Sure.
Many of us, when we look back, whatever we are doing, sometimes we may do the planning. Sometimes then we go for delivery, but we forgot to engage. And some people, they may engage and try to deliver, but they forgot to plan. It could be, you know, there are many kind variation of, you know, how we go back. But at the end of the day, if we able to fulfill all these three areas, God willing, we're able to achieve our goal. Setuju?
Yes, totally agree.
Okay, that is, if you agree with that, Cik Azman, yeah, I would like to define leadership. What is leadership then? According to this program, definition of leadership basically is plan your future, care to engage, commit to deliver. That is leadership. And again here, you compare whatever answers given just now. Some people, they focus more on engagement. They forgot about planning. Some of your answer just now maybe focus on delivering and forgot about engagement. Just now, Cik Azman mentioned that the importance to have emotional intelligence. That is particularly closely related to engagement. So the moment, whatever activities that we do having have all these three elements, basically you are what I call, you are leading the project. Follow me?
Yeah.
Any bangkangan keras yang tak setuju ke apa? Martin, what you have to say about this, Martin? Because I heard just now, makan, tidur apa?
Eat, sleep, repeat.
Okay. Maybe yeah. You would like to, maybe Martin, you would like to give your point of view here.
You see, it is perfectly fitting. Eat, sleep, repeat. Eh? So, plan the future, engage, commit to deliver. No, just kidding. No. I think it's very valid that leadership, especially when we put this in the context of organization, I would see that would be the way how leader can work or how leadership should work in the so-called normal times. So in the normal times. In difficult situation, it might be a little bit different because it might be more ad hoc. But here in this content of organizational leadership, I would say that is a good approach. I like that. To plan the future, to care, to engage and commit to deliver. So not only relevant in projects, but throughout the whole way of an organization is organized, run. That is a really nice approach. Nice approach.
Martin, you know what? What I'm doing here now? I try to lead this particular session. You know how?
How?
First,
you engage me.
I have planned the future. I mean, I have planned the seminar.
Yeah.
How to deliver. And down here, why I, engage with you guys, to give your point of view. It's basically just to apply care to engage.
Correct.
And last but not least, Lester, I hope by the end of the day, all of us have that commitment to deliver. So basically, I try to apply this concept I call FED, Future Engaged Leader, in this very particular program.
Okay, Tuamio, can I add something?
Yes, please.
Okay, actually, Tuamio and I have the same guru.
Yeah.
So actually, this Future Engaged Deliver is from a leadership guru called Steve Radcliffe. Yeah.
Sharif, I'll share that later. Lepas ni.
Okay. So I did mention in my feedback just now.
Yeah.
It's leadership is about looking at the future, engaging the people, and delivering results. So I have used it in all my leadership programs.
Yeah,
and maybe you can share a bit more.
Sure, like. I will.
Martin. It's from the book Leadership Plain and Simple.
I have not finished with Martin yet.
Sorry for interjecting.
Okay, Martin, just matter of curiosity.
Yeah.
You have any leaders, any particular leader that you look up at?
Yeah, there is one.
Don't mention the name. I just want to picture they'll call his face or her face in your mind. Yeah? Okay. Now, I ask you one question. Since you look up at him as a leader, do you think, looking at that face, whether he or she good in planning, good in engaging, and good in delivering? What say you?
Yes to two categories.
Okay.
Some category that was a little bit of weakness, but can compensate with others. So that is what we normally do. Yeah. Good. So it's not that expecting that you need to fulfill every three categories to the best. But two, yeah. I would strongly agree in, and maybe I'm very blessed in that sense, that most of my mentors have fulfilled at least two. So sometimes in one category, there we always have a little bit of weakness. But in this way, I would say I was very blessed to have these mentors with me.
Okay, Martin, if I, based on your input here, what can I say here? Though your particular leaders, that the one you look up at, may have only two out of three, but reality-wise, maybe that particular thing is not his strength or her strength, he leveraged on others. He knows how to leverage others so that at the end of the day, he complete the loop. Future
Correct.
Engaged
yeah.
deliver.
I agree on that.
Yeah.
So that's what I just meant. Yeah, which I'm saying, maybe it is completed by using others because it is not his or her particular strengths. So it's
exactly.
Okay. Yeah.
Exactly. Okay, thank you. I need to go a little bit fast, sorry, yeah, because time is so I got a few more things, what number of things to come to share here. Okay, at the end of the day, as what Cik Sharif mentioned just now, this idea FED came from a gentleman named Steve Radcliffe. Yeah. And he's one of the so-called top leadership guru from UK. Yeah? And he's an author of a simple book, Leadership Plain and Simple. I must say, my dear friends, Leadership Plain and Simple is at the top of my favorite leadership books. Yeah. So simple, but somehow rather it really touched me. Yeah, really changed me altogether about leadership. Because before I read this book, I thought leadership is so complicated. But at the end of the day, I think I have the opportunity to learn from him himself, because we invite him to Tenaga a couple of years back. And I must say, wow, I just wonder if the world really subscribe to this idea when it comes to leadership. I think this world can be a better place to be. But anyway, having said that, let's hear what is his definition of leadership. It's to iterate again. Yeah? First, he said, in essence, leadership is always start in the future with ideas and thoughts about how you like things to be. Basically, planning. Yeah. Here we talk about being up to something. Yeah. And a simple word, the word future. And secondly, according to Radcliffe, leadership is you have to engage with people so that they want to build that future with you. These people could be you yourself to influence yourself or influence others. Yeah. And the words in simple term, being in touch with what you care about. This is engage. Yeah. And thirdly, to complete the definition, he stated that, and then you draw the best from yourself or others to make things happen. This is deliver. Yeah. And simple term, going for it. And in other words, the word deliver. So whatever it is, Radcliffe define leadership simply as future, engage, and deliver. If you can remember these three words, whatever we do, I think, in other words, I can put it safely to say that we are what we call developing our leadership slowly but surely. Yeah, whatever we do, nak pergi pasar ke, nak pergi cuti ke, Tuan Syarif, yeah? Nak pergi balik ke, you ada element future engage liver, without you notice, you are developing our own leadership. So, let's hear a video from Radcliffe himself, what he has to say about leadership. Let's kita ponder upon this video.
I don't know why we're making this topic of leadership so complicated. I had to stand back and review it all a few years ago for a client, and I thought about the years of consulting, I thought about the hundreds of books I've read on the topic, and I realised, blimey, leadership only comes in three parts, whatever it is you're leading for. It always starts in the future. Where do we want to go? What do we want to build? What is the future we want? That's the essence of leadership. Second, you've then got to get out there and engage people so they want to come with you. Third, you've then got to get on and deliver. And it's as simple as that. Future, engage, deliver. I don't know why people are making it more complicated. I believe leadership is the ingredient in an organisation which gets the best out of all the other ingredients. Yes, you'll have a strategy and you'll have plans and you'll have processes and people. And leadership then comes along either to waste the potential that's present in those ingredients or get the best out of them and bring a strategy alive, bring people alive.
Okay, that's I call it some insight from Radcliffe. Yeah? So I hope that from now on, at least for this particular program, when we talk about leadership, it's all about future, engage, deliver. Yeah, I hope that we subscribe to that, at least in this particular program. Okay, having said that, to put things in perspective, yeah, so that we see the whole thing clearer, yeah, I would like to have this so-called framework whatever it is, when we talk about leadership.
I don't.
Okay. Okay. It's all started with a goal, up to something, and obviously you want the result. In other words, to make things happen. So in between these two so-called things, we have leadership. And what is leadership? First is future. What is future? Basically, plan based on the future you want. And then plus engage. What is engage? That is, you need to have engage others if you are to succeed. And last but not least, is about deliver. Yeah, deliver is what you need to make things happen and get result. No hanky-panky, straight to the point. Yeah, this is what we need to do, no matter how small or how big is the particular activities. Okay, maybe I would like to ask from Cik Puan Olivia kita. Yeah, Olivia, what you have to say about this so-called on whatever that we have covered so far? Olivia, over to you.
Yes, I'm so sorry because my camera, actually my name is Angie, my camera got some problems, so I use my daughter's account, so that's why it's called Olivia. All right, very good, Tomio. I really enjoyed today's your explanation regarding this leadership, and it's a FED, it's something that, yeah, everything is in our mind, but we do not know how to take this out and put it in the leadership. So thank you very much. I think it's really, really good today, you know. Yeah. Thanks to Sharif as well, bring our Tomio in. Yeah. And for the leadership, yes, come to this leadership. It's not easy because to do things alone is very easy. We can do what we want, but it's the thing that when we want to lead people and come with us, that is the problem. Yeah, because we all are different. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you, Angie. Yeah, so Angie, right? Sorry, yeah.
Angie.
Sorry. Yes. So what I can gather from Angie's input, yeah, here by having this leadership being defined as future engaged leader, I think we can what we can do next, yeah, we can use this so-called framework to develop leadership objectively, because normally, when we talk about leadership, there are 1001 matters. Yeah? And it's normally, it's not that objective. Very difficult to measure whether we achieve it or not. In this matter, if you look carefully, if you do future engaged leader properly, what is the outcome? You get the result. There is no alternative to that. Yeah? If you don't do if you do your future engaged leader properly, what will happen? You will never get your result. Or rather, you may have problem to achieve your result. Yeah.
Yes.
So by putting in that matter, don't you see that we are now trying, or rather we have an idea how to develop leadership in an objective manner?
Yes. So tell me, is it means that objective level means, for example, with the result, like whether it's 80%, 30%, something that we can see?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Angie, I don't know about you or whether you have involved in leadership development. Yeah, just for your information, this is my personal experience. Yeah, whenever I met any leaders who intend to develop leadership among their people, yeah, one number one question that they ask me, Ella, can you give me result out of this leadership development? Very difficult if you just teach theory. Yeah, but what I did here, or rather what we did here, yeah, we tied up the so-called the output of leadership to the result they realize. And it could be 80%, 50%, or whatever. But then again, the best part is that you can relate whatever you do at FED to the result. And you can see what went wrong or what's missing. Where's the gap? So that is the very, very important insight that we have so far. And mind you, When I discuss with other this so-called leadership developer from any organization, the way I look at it is, it's not objective. And when it's not objective, what we can see in the market, yeah, people not willing to invest in leadership development. Yeah, they are investing, but then again, they have this so-called doubt whether they can get the result out of it. So I hope you see what I see just now. Yeah. So based on that, yeah. Next, yeah, I would like to, what you call this? Just hold on, yeah. next, yeah. I think before we move on, I would like to ask second question. Second basic question. Question, why is leadership important? We have just answered first question, what is leadership? Now we try to answer why is leadership important. Again, Tuan Syarif, Mak, kita bagi satu minit pada all our friends to type their so-called their answer in the chat box. And again, please don't enter the enter button until I ask you to do so. Okay, 1 minute, shoot. Silakan. Why is leadership important? We welcome different answers, different perspective. The more different we are, the merrier we are. Yeah. So again, semua jawapan betul, tak ada salah. Yeah. Okay, silakan. Wow, Tuan Syarif, masa sangat mencemburui lah.
We have like,
but anyway,
like
I janji
40 more minutes, huh? 39 janji, more minutes exactly.
I janji 12:30 kita habis. Siap tak siap kita berhenti kat mana kita sampai. Okay.
Apalah, not so rigid lah. Yeah. Kita boleh, tak ada hal.
I don't know, kalau everyone willing to, you know, go beyond 30, then...
Kalau tak habis kan, macam makan tak apa, tak puas makan.
No.
Tak kenyang.
Okay. Okay, done. 1 minute. Over. Please enter your enter button. Tuan Syarif, again, tolong baca.
Okay, I'll start with siapa ni? Gina, eh? In order for the organization to move in one agreed direction and pace. Martin, no leader, no direction. Simple, sweet. Macam biasa, Martin punya style.
Okay.
Rinaldi, I suppose he's from Indonesia. Yeah. Everybody, community, organization must have goals. So FED, leadership is important. Yes. Nick, Muhammad Faris, to meet objective defined. Amir Jumaat, to ensure everyone and everything stay on course. I ingat satu statement. Stay the course by one of my sifu. Olivia or Angie, yeah? Leadership is important as it can help us to achieve our goals, result with objective. Azman, leading with clear objectives, no shaira to achieve the expected result in stipulated time and in harmony. Okay, Patricia, drive others for better future. Danny, we are hungry for result. Okay, and Zul, otherwise chaos. Okay. Dr. Jimsia, to coordinate, help to work effectively, I think, what she meant. Dr. Sufi, precise result. Okay, that's all.
Okay, thank you. Yeah. Okay, again, I think we all have a good intention here, yeah, when come to this question, yeah. But then again, I would like to keep it simple. Yeah. But then again, never ever think that this simple thing is simple, yeah, because to arrive to that simplicity is not easy. Yeah. So having said that, I would like to define or rather respond to this question by simply saying that why leadership is important, simply because leadership is an enabler to make things happen. The key word here is an enabler. Yeah. In other words, without proper leadership, we are unable to achieve or rather to make things happen. As simple as that. I think having said this, I think basically you can actually reflect back to whatever thing happened around us. Yeah, be it at the international level, national level, organizational level, hatta dalam rumah sekalipun. Yeah, this is where leadership is important. Yeah, and the way I look at it, it's high time for us to what we call to develop this leadership. Yeah, from very beginning. Unfortunately, there is no clear framework how to develop leadership. Later on, towards the end of the module of this program, I will share you one methodology how to develop leadership in a very simple yet objective. I'll do that later. Yeah. Okay. Having said that, just to ponder, yeah. Let's say, let's look at this stool, this three-legged stool. Yeah. I would like to say something like this. To sit comfortably on the stool, basically to have a good leadership, the three legs of the stool basically represent future enslaver must be solid. If one of the so-called legs are not solid, you can imagine what sort of leadership that we're going to have. This is really something for us to ponder. This is something really that we need to work on so that we can make at the end of the day our life better than yesterday. Okay, my dear friends, I will take what we call 5 minutes break, but then I would like to main teka-teki dengan you all. Boleh ke Tuan Syarif?
Boleh.
Because I think we are dealing with a very, very, what you call serious topic. I think we take a break. Let's kita main teka-teki sedikit. Boleh? Okay, siapa tekan Tuan Syarif? Tuan Syarif? Whoever answer mula-mula, dia menang. Tuan Syarif?
Alright. I'll look at the chat. But
You tengok chat. Okay. Jawapan dekat chat, tak boleh cakap mulut, ya. Yeah?
Okay,
apa ni Tuan Syarif? Yang menang dalam teka-teki ni paling paling banyak sekali dia punya jawapan, eh? Yang banyak betul, saya bagi satu buku.
Okay.
I have books. I don't know. There are many books. Yeah, I can give any of the books.
Bagi dia orang leadership plain and simple. Order dekat mana? Order dekat Denny.
Okay, ready? Okay, teka-teki nombor satu. Tuan Syarif, ready ya? Just beritahu siapa menang, pemenang dia. Okay, jawab soalan ni. A woman shoots her husband, then holds him underwater for 5 minutes. Next, she hangs him. Right after, they enjoy a lovely dinner. Explain. Tap dekat chat box. What be your answer to this? Anyone? Syarif? Tuan Syarif? Any answer so far?
Ada. So far, photographer. She is a photographer.
Yes, correct.
Gina, congratulations.
Okay, now puzzle number two. Yeah.
Okay, Gina. First, Gina dapat.
A barrel of water weighs 60 pounds. What must you put in it for it to weigh 40 pounds? Anyone? Tuan Syarif, just get ready.
Okay.
So far,
Martin put there 40 pounds. Azman put there water. Rinaldi kata fire. Gina? Tak ada apa-apa.
Okay, I give the answer now.
A hole. Nobody got it right.
Okay, third puzzle. A bus driver goes the wrong way on a one-way street. He passes the cops, but they don't stop him. Why? Ini bukan bagi senang, bukan bagi orang relax. Tuan Syarif, bagi orang sakit kepala ada.
Stress lah. Oh, stress.
Stress.
Martin as usual. Hari Raya mood kata. The police in a good mood.
Okay, I give the answer now.
Okay.
He was walking.
Gina.
Huh?
Gina said he is walking.
Betul lah tu.
Betul lah.
So Gina contender dapat buku.
Gina okay. Dua kali betul. So okay, ada lagi ke?
Ada lagi satu. Last.
Lagi last.
The more there is, the less you see. Who? What am I?
But anyway, Gina still wins. the best of three.
Yeah.
Even if other people got it right.
Okay. Anyone? Tuan Syarif, I give the answer now?
Yep. Gina say he, Azman say he is on the right way. Money, darkness. Okay, nobody got it right.
Yeah. Okay. Next. Okay.
Ada lagi. Okay.
What types of dress can never be worn? Saya ingat senang ke ni? Okay, I bagi answer. Tuan Syarif.
Gina kata address. Patricia kata address.
Okay, the address. First one.
But Gina wrote it first. So Gina won 3 times already.
Wah. Okay, tak apa. We go next one.
Tapi Rinaldi, very interesting answer. Pizza dressing.
Pizza dressing.
Okay. Last one. Eh?
Forward, I'm heavy, but backward, I'm not. What am I?
My backside. Yo.
This little bit tricky. Forward, I'm heavy, but backward, I'm not. What am I?
Banyaklah mati on behalf.
Okay, the answer is?
Nobody got it right.
Okay, yeah.
Ton, so, not.
Ton and not, yeah. Okay, tak apa. Let's kita move on. I stop kat sini. Masa sangat tidak mengizinkan.
I'm oh, so Gina, sorry. You can claim your prize, huh?
Yes. Later, Tuan Syarif.
I will share her number to you.
Okay, good. Yeah. Okay, sorry to take a break sekejap. Tapi I think we still need a break. So that now let's go back into this leadership subject. Yeah.
Roughly half an hour more, yeah.
Okay, sure. Okay, my dear friends, this little bit, I would like for us to ponder here. What is the difference between the first and the second equation here? You can see the difference. And what is the difference and what will be the impact be? Okay, so I repeat the question. Yeah, I would like you to compare between these two equations and then what's the difference? And secondly, what's the impact for both equation. Yeah? Okay. Anyone? What you can see here? Yeah? Tuan Haji Azman nak say something to Haji Azman?
Okay. The second frame is a complete leadership
with
goal and result.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas the first one is just a framework mm-hmm. with nowhere.
Okay. Okay, faham. Itu kata Tuan Haji Azman. Apa kata Dr. Jimmy Siah kita pula? Doc, maybe you would like to hear your point of view pula, if you don't mind. What's the difference between the first and second equation? And what will be the impact be? Wan Yamsha tak ada ya? Tak apa.
Can I read somebody from the chat?
Okay, silakan.
Okay, Rinaldi has something interesting. Hmm. Without goal and result, FED is meaningless. Shall I add to Rinaldi? Without goal and result, FED will have FED plus UP. Fed up.
Okay.
And Olivia Chan or Angie, yeah.
Angie.
She says first is without goals and result. The first one on top.
Okay, good.
So it's meaningless lah, basically, yeah.
Yeah. Right. Okay, just let me just give my my point of view. What is the difference between these two equations? If you look at when we talk about leadership development, yeah. Many organizations, the way I look at it, they just share theory. And theory basically is the first equation. They just share what is leadership, future engaged driver, period. Yeah. But actually, when you talk about leadership development, you must what you call share this idea of leadership and then leverage this idea straight away into any particular project, initiative, or whatever you call it, yeah. In your current work. If you don't do that, then you can see, yeah, people thought that they know leadership, but actually they don't really understand leadership. The only after they apply the concept in any of their initiative or their project, then only they understand leadership inside out, or else is purely theory, and we have enough theory. We want action, as what Danny said earlier. Yeah. So I hope, my dear friend, you can resist this thing clearly. Yeah. Okay. Now look into what we call, let's do some kind of self-reflection with regards to FED by asking ourselves this matter, this question. Okay. Cuba tengok dekat layar ni. Red color, for red color, that means to say we have gaps in that particular area. For example, the first one, future red color, it shows that you don't have the capability to do planning. Engage red color means that we don't have the capability to engage with people. Thirdly, we don't engage deliver. We don't have the capability to deliver. In other words, we have gaps there. Yeah. So just take a minute. Yeah. Let's ponder. Currently, where am I? Am I on the first so-called all red color? Or we are good in planning, but we have issues at engage or deliver or whatever? Yeah. So this is a good start, yeah, to really to gauge our leadership capability. Simple, but it is very practical. Yeah. And mind you, under each category, under each future engage deliver, yeah, I must say, under future alone, there are thousand and thousand and thousand books written on how to plan. Similarly to engage, there are thousand and thousand material, yeah, talking on engagement alone. That's including emotional intelligence, as what Haji Azman mentioned just now. Similarly, when we talk about how to deliver things, there are thousand and thousand and thousand material how to deliver. So in other words, it is up to us if we identify certain gaps in a particular engagement. For example, if we have problem to listen to people, because to engage people, we need to have capability to listen to people. So if you have problem in listening to people, so my humble suggestion, go out there, develop your listening skill so that you can make yourself better in engagement. So again, my dear friend, this is only on the surface, yeah? But if you deep down into it, as I mentioned earlier, there are thousand and thousand and thousand material written or being written on the matter. So whatever it is, no matter where we are, everyone, you can reflect on our own level. Yeah. There are four basic questions that we need to ask ourselves with regards to where we are. First question is, am I leading in this manner? For example, let's say we are good in future, but we are poor in engagement and deliver. And then ask yourself, am I leading in this manner? Yeah, first question. Second question, if you are leading in this manner, question, but is it easy for you to achieve your goal? Yeah. And thirdly, again, if you're leading in this manner, how you make people around you feel? How do the people around you feel? Are they okay with you? Are they stressed with you, Tuan Sharif? Maybe you stress dengan I dulu kot, Tuan Sharif.
Ada kot.
Ada kot. Now you can laugh lah, Tuan Sharif.
release stress.
And last but not least, if this is a situation, what shall I do about it? How can I improve my leadership? Simple question, but again, it's not that easy. Yeah? Jadi, my dear friend, I don't want to talk much about it because time is not on our side. Yeah? But for the next maybe about 10 minutes, yeah, I would like to share three video so that through video, I think you can see better. Yeah, the impact of, let's say, future engage deliver. Yeah, so I will start to share first video, which is going to focus on future. So on this video, I will share with you this so-called Elon Musk has to offer with regards to the future of
SpaceX.
SpaceX, yeah. So let's see. from his so-called this video, what you can learn from Elon Musk. Yeah, okay, let's watch this video. Okay, while watching this video, please also consider the statement down there. Yeah, this is the, do you see this statement in Elon Musk? So from there, you can see clearly, I hope, yeah, you can see the impact of plan the future. Okay, let's get to watch benda ni sama-sama.
Earth-Mars synchronization happens roughly every 2 years. So every 2 years, there's an opportunity to fly to Mars. So then in 2024, we want to try to fly 4 ships, two of which would be crewed, and two cargo and two crew. The goal of these initial missions is to find the best source of water. That's for the first mission. And then the second mission, the goal is to build the propellant plant. So we should, particularly with 6 ships, there have plenty of landed mass to construct the propellant depot, which will consist of a large array of solar panels, very large array, and then everything necessary to mine and refine water, and then draw the CO2 out of the atmosphere, and then create and store deep cryo CH4 and O2. Then build up the base, starting obviously with one ship, then multiple ships, then start building out the city, then making the city bigger, even bigger.
Okay, my dear friends, based on that video, what is your takeaway when we talk about future? Anyone? Do you think Elon Musk joking here? Adakah dia main-main je ke? Ataupun how you see Elon Musk in this video with regards to plan the future? Is it very serious? Is he joking or make a joke or whatever? I don't know. What we can learn here? Anyone? I nak invite one person to give your thoughts about what you see here. Anyone? Anyone, Cik Abi, Dr. Cik Nick kita, Tuan Nick, Muhammad Haris, can you share your thoughts? What's your takeaway from this video with regards to future? Silakan.
Okay, basically, he start small lah. He start from 2 first, but he give a time frame. So his time frame every 2 years to expand. So he cannot go one big shot to achieve his goal.
What value that you see from Elon Musk when come to plan their future, Nick?
He should start somewhere to build up the base over there. So that's my thought lah. So then the thing is this man, he don't care whatever result. So he just put first.
Yeah. Okay, Cik Nick, if you ask me, one trait that I learned from Elon Musk when it comes to plan the future, he is so serious with his plan. Though the rest of the world say that he is joking, he's crazy or whatever. If you remember in year 2012, around that time when he started to craft this plan, people thought that he is joking, he's crazy, utterly crazy, but he just couldn't care. So the question here, when we plan the future, one trait that we need to have, we need, before we want to share our plan with people, we ourselves need to what we call to really, really buy in on the plan, or else people will not follow us. When come to engagement letter, we have big, big problem because we ourselves do not believe in our own plan. So I hope that, of course, we can talk so many things on this matter, but one thing that we can hear, when you plan your future, ensure that we ourselves believe in that plan. If not, forget to share with others, or you thought that other people can trust, will believe on your plan and blah, blah, blah. So that's one lesson from Elon Musk with regards to future. Let's go into second video where we're going to talk about the engagement. So in this video, next video, you will see a fisherman, how he engaged with his so-called, his trainee. Yeah, this one young man. You see how he engaged with this young man, and later, what trait that this fisherman have here that make him good in engagement. Let's watch this video.
Sometimes in life, we search for opportunities. Opportunities of life change. Moments of leadership aren't always met with a fanfare, a spectacle, or pageantry. They're selfless and noble. They're inherent, instinctive. Authority doesn't always equate to leadership. A leader knows that teamwork is always better than going at it alone. And being reliable can carry more weight than any position or power. A leader goes the extra mile when you're tired and when it doesn't make sense to. But integrity is about doing the right thing when no one is looking. It's not about having all the answers, but taking what's in your cup and pouring it into someone else's that is less full. People follow those who are selfless and open-handed. A leader sees the potential in someone and blows wind into their sails. You go throughout your day hoping to unlock the potential in someone, hoping that something clicks, and sometimes the day ends wondering if any significant difference has been made, if any ground has been covered, if there is any tangible evidence of your investment, if it was just lost on those you bled, yielding no return. There will be times when you feel like giving up on those whom you've led, when you think that all that effort, all the guidance and direction is all for naught. Please, don't give up on us. Even though we may not be asking for it, we are desperate for you to lead us. Because we are watching. We are paying attention. We're begging for you to keep going. You help us realize that leadership is something worth fighting for, worth running after. What we get is rich, and it's greater than any monetary reward. It's been said leadership doesn't happen in a day. It happens daily. And your influence on us will have ripples felt for days to come.
Okay. Di sini, tuan-tuan rumpuan, it's not about you pandai ke apa. It's all about whether you care or not. This is where you need emotional intelligence at your best. Ya, tuan-tuan Azman? Without emotional intelligence, forget about engagement. Because engagement is about here. It's not about here. Many people try to engage using logic. Sudan apa jadi? Koyak. Saya gelak sebab apa tuan? Sebab saya banyak buat mistake bab tu. Terutama dengan Tuan Syarif. Because of that, Tuan Syarif, I nak bayar hutang I. You know what, Tuan Syarif? Yep. I will do for you.
Yes.
Before this, I tak pernah ucapkan selamat hari jadi pada you. Tapi kali ni, hari ni Tuan Syarif, saya nak ucapkan selamat hari jadi pada you.
Oh, thank you, Tuan.
Jadi kalau you don't mind, my dear friends semua, mari kita nyanyi lagu Happy Birthday Tuan, untuk Tuan Syarif. Boleh tak?
Wah.
Okay.
Mari kita
mulakan. 1, 2, mula. Happy birthday to you.
Okay, terima kasih. I'm today 16 years old. Officially, dah warga emas lah, 16 years old.
61 years old. Okay, I dah bayar hutang you, Tuan Syarif. Tapi, you see, cara I salah. Sebab I make him to ni. You have to do it casually. Do it from the heart, Tuan Syarif.
Betul.
So, I hope this is a good demonstration how to engage.
Betul.
Right? Okay, now let's go to the third video on deliver. Okay, I would like you to observe this video to a person called Skipper. Skipper is the leader in this next video. I just want you to ask one question to yourself. While you're watching this video, how come does the leader able, you know, to influence the lead, the follower to be like what you see in this video? Okay, lepas habis video, I will ask this question. Okay, let's watch this video. Very interesting video. Okay, 1, 2, 2.
We're going. Look. Analysis. It looks like a small incandescent bulb designed to indicate something out of the ordinary, like a malfunction.
I find it pretty and somewhat hypnotic.
That too, sir. Right. Rico, manual. Mm-hmm.
Problemo solved.
Sir, we may be out of fuel.
What makes you think that?
We've lost engine one. And engine two is no longer on fire.
Buckle up, boys. Don't look dull. This might get hairy.
Attention, this is your captain speaking. I've got good news and bad news. The good news is we'll be landing immediately. The bad news is we're crash landing. When it comes to air travel, we know you have no choice whatsoever. But thanks again for choosing Air Penguin.
I know you won't mind when I tell you.
Come on, tell me anything. Tell me what?
I broke your iPod.
What?
The buttons were so small. It made me mad.
The horror.
I'm sorry.
I'm gonna kill you.
It was an accident.
Rico, you've had your fun. Pull up. Gear down. Now you just want to kiss the ground. Just a little peck, a smooch, like you're kissing your sister. I said kiss it! Now just a little break. Just a tap. A little whisper.
I believe that's checkmate.
Only two passengers unaccounted for, Skipper.
That's a number I can live with. Good landing, boys. Who says a penguin can't fly?
Okay. If you ask me about that, this particular video, all this element basically is what we require when we go to when we talk about deliver. Yeah, I think that is very important. Yeah, and secondly, back to my earlier question. Yeah, how this skipper able to influence his follower to behave in that manner? If you ask me personally, how he able to do that? Because he have done his homework. What I meant by homework, because he have do planning carefully, he have engaged with the people prior to this. That's why the lead, the people or the follower willingly follow skipper. So I think this is something for us to ponder. Yeah, when we talk about leadership, basically leadership is all about future, engage, deliver. Yeah. So again, Martin, maybe I go back to you, Martin. Yeah? Based on this slide, yeah, I think we are this so-called summary, yeah, from what we have covered before this. What is your takeaway here, Martin? Maybe you would like to share with all of us.
Definitely a very good session. For me, I have never seen it in that way of future, engage, and deliver. Personally, and I like that you have the points there that we should look into which area we should improve. Yeah, so there definitely myself is also not on the three blue dots or the three blue squares. So most probably I would see myself maybe on the future and the deliver part, that is okay. But the engaging part, I think there's, or I believe there's my area where I need to improve as well. So very good session. I like also the videos, very inspiring videos that you have put there. So overall, I feel this model is very well, and I have been keeping a little bit searching. It's a lot of material also in the internet about that. So that is very good. I will study that. Thank you.
Okay, Martin. Good. Yeah. Okay. Now come to the so-called third question. I have covered what is leadership, why leadership is important. Third question, how to develop leadership. Yeah, based on FED, of course. Yeah. So before I elaborate more on how to develop this, yeah. Of course, I will cover only on the surface. Yeah, to know more, you can always PM me. Yeah, then we can talk further. But then again, to kickstart on this development, something to ponder. Yeah, whatever it is, my dear friend. Yeah, leadership development needs consistency. Agree? For whatever it is, you want to be successful, you need to be consistent, right? But when you talk about leadership development specifically, I would like you to observe this particular video, again, about 3 minutes video, yeah? From a gentleman called Simon Sinek. I think many of us aware about him, yeah? He will talk about what is required when we want to develop leadership. Very interesting, simple, but that again to me is very, very important. Yeah. Okay, let's be listen to this short video. Why, what we need for leadership development. Yeah. Okay, let's listen to this.
Do you love your wife?
Yes.
Prove it. Like, what's the metric? Give me the number that helps me know, right? Because when you met her, you didn't love her. Now you love her. Right? Tell me the day the love happened. It's an impossible question. But it's not that it doesn't exist, it's that it's much easier to prove over time. Right? We just have the same thing. It's about transition. So if you were to go to the gym, right? If you go to the gym and you work out and you come back and you look in the mirror, you will see nothing. And if you go to the gym the next day and you come back and you look in the mirror, you will see nothing. So clearly there's no results, can't be measured, it must not be effective. So we quit, right? Or if you fundamentally believe that this is the right course of action, you stick with it. Like in a relationship, I bought her flowers and I wished her happy birthday, and she doesn't love me. Clearly I'll give up. That's not what happens. If you believe there's something there, you commit yourself to an act of service. You commit yourself to the regime, the exercise. You can screw it up. You can eat chocolate cake one day, you can skip a day or two, you know, it allows for that. But if you stick with it consistently, I'm not exactly sure what day, but I know you'll start getting into shape. I know it. And the same with the relationship. It's not about the events. It's not about intensity. It's about consistency, right? You go to the dentist twice a year, your teeth will fall out. You have to brush your teeth every day for 2 minutes. What does brushing your teeth twice a day for 2 minutes do? Nothing. Unless you do it every day, twice a day for 2 minutes. Right? It's the consistency. Going to the gym for 9 hours does not get you into shape. Working out every day for 20 minutes gets you into shape. The problem is we treat leadership with intensity. We have a 2-day offsite, we invite a bunch of speakers, we give everybody a certificate. You're a leader, right? Those things are like going to the dentist. They're very important. They're good for reminding us or getting us back on track, learning new lessons. But it's the daily practice of all the monotonous, little, boring things like brushing your teeth that matter the most. She didn't fall in love with you because you remembered her birthday and bought her flowers on Valentine's Day. She fell in love with you because when you woke up in the morning, you said good morning to her before you checked your phone. She fell in love with you because when you went to the fridge to get yourself a drink, you got her one without even asking. She fell in love with you because when you had an amazing day at work and she came home and she had a terrible day at work, you didn't say, yeah, but let me tell you about my day. You sat and listened to her awful day and you didn't say a thing about your amazing day. This is why she fell in love with you. I can't tell you exactly what day, and it was no particular thing you did. It was the accumulation of all of those little things that she woke up one day and is as if she pressed a button. She goes, I love him, right? Leadership is exactly the same. There's no event. There's no thing I can tell you you have to do that your people will trust you. It doesn't work that way. It's an accumulation of lots and lots of little things that anyone by themselves is innocuous and useless. Literally, pointless by themselves. People will look at little things that are good leadership practices and say, that won't work, and you're absolutely right. But if you do it consistently, and you do it in combination with lots of other little things, like saying good morning to someone, that looking them in the eye. My friend George, who's a 3-star general in the Marine Corps, he says his test for leadership, and I love this, he goes, his test for a good leader is if you ask somebody how their day is going, you actually care about the answer. The number of times we're walking to a meeting, we're rushing, we go, how are you? Not good, I gotta get to you later, I'm late for a meeting. If you ask the question, you are standing there and you're listening to the answer. It's those little innocuous things that you do over and over and over and over that people will say, I love my job. Not I like my job. I like my job means, yeah, the challenge is great, they pay me well, I like the people. I love my job means I don't want to work anywhere else. I don't care how much somebody else is willing to pay me. I'm devoted to the people here and I care desperately about the people here as if they were my family. In business, we have colleagues and coworkers. In the military, they have brothers and sisters. That's how they think of each other. If you really have a strong corporate culture, the people will think of each other like brothers and sisters. It's like a family, right? No, brothers and sisters. Deep love, fight, but the love doesn't go away. Bicker, the love doesn't go away. And I'll fight with my sister, but if you threaten my sister, you're gonna have to deal with me. Right? We'll fight internally, we'll bicker with each other, but nobody's gonna hurt each other, and if anything from the outside shows up, you're looking at a unified front. Brothers and sisters. Now, how do you create brothers and sisters out of strangers? Common beliefs, common values, you know? Parents, in other words, executives who care about their children's success, who care to raise their children, teach them skills, discipline them when necessary, help them build their self-confidence so that they can go on and achieve something more than you could have ever imagined achieving for yourself. That's leadership.
Okay, my dear friend, a thought about how to develop leadership. Having said that, that's why, my dear friend, in Tenaga, we have created this one particular module that we call Culture of Champions. Journey of Growth, a 16-week program, yeah, to develop leadership. But it is not. Can someone off their audio?
Raymond, maybe? I think. Let me mute.
I don't know. Someone, I think, need to off.
I think Raymond audio. Weber, you, I better be on mute.
So okay, let me check. Yeah. So if you're really seriously about developing leadership, it's no point we talk about theory after theory after theory. Yeah. So for that matter, because we really want, if we seriously want to develop leadership, for that matter, we have this so-called Culture of Champion, whereby comprise series of sharing ideas plus applying the ideas to in particular area of work, and then we follow up with coaching. So there will be a series of this so-called matter. Now this is no joke. Yeah? This is very serious matter. Yeah, and especially during the apply the idea to the project and the coaching session. This is where, from my personal experience, the real learning happened. Yeah. So then from here, basically, what idea that we share in order to create this matter, again, from observation, we need to attack the so-called the mindset. For that matter, you can see here, 1, 2, 3, and 4, basically is a webinar, yeah, whereby we share how to develop these four type of mindset: growth mindset, leadership mindset, business mindset, and collaborative mindset. In fact, this particular program, yeah, is part and parcel of the program called Developing Leadership Mindset. Yeah, so you can see how we go about doing it, because it is not about theory, yeah, it's about how it relates to your own work or your own life. That's what really matters. Yeah. So having said all this, how we see, how this is going to benefit us, yeah, it's all started with this equation again: goal, leadership, results. Yeah. And then we will focus on these three areas: future, engage, deliver. In order to help us to develop the future, engage, deliver, we come up with the four modules that I mentioned just now. Because all this module, growth mindset, leadership mindset, that they're touched, here and there on future, engage, deliver. So at the end of the day, it gives you some kind of a good start to develop your leadership. Yeah. And in doing so, we also apply what we call, this is what I call, we start to have build up. Yeah. We build up the momentum for us to lead things. Yeah. And also, in some organization, they are focusing on what we call their core values. So we blend all this practice with the core values, because again, core values, they touch about the emotional part and the spiritual part of us, not only intellectual. Many people, when come to values, they only talk about intellectual. Yeah, they put the so-called value on the so-called on the wall and expect people to subscribe to it. That's nuts. Yeah. So we need to talk about it, to practice it. And this is must involve the emotional part of us and also our spiritual part. Yeah. So if we doing it in this manner, God willing, slowly but surely, we can create what we call breakthrough in whatever we do. Yeah. This whole thing is what I call as our culture of champions flywheel. And in applying this, again, my dear friend, we really, really what we call subscribe to what we call common sense. Yeah. Because in order to adopt and adapt this idea in one particular area, definitely we need a lot of common sense. But now again, I think as you guys are fully aware, common sense is not that common nowadays. Yeah. So I think again, this is what the world requires. This is all basic. Yeah. It's nothing rocket science about it. It's so simple. What different about it? Because we get all this idea that we being, you know, be introduced to in instead of looking at it in silo. For example, look at growth mindset in silo of leadership in silo of business in silo of collaborative. Then that's what the problem started. We need to get all this idea complement each other. Martin, yeah. When you talk about business mindset, this is where I use BMC. And I use BMC in different approach. Danny can be my so-called, Danny actually have gone through that. I think Danny can, you know, can be my good testimony lah on that, Danny. Yeah? So this is the whole picture that we have to offer in order to develop leadership. I must say, this is not a quick fix. If I can do it in a quick fix manner, I'll be a multi-billionaire nowadays. Yeah. Again, it is it's a journey, and a journey that something that we need to subscribe to. It's not only touch and go. It's something that we need to adhere to. God willing, we arrive to our so-called destination. Yeah. So, in conclusion, my dear friend, yeah. This is the main point that I cover for the past almost 1 hour and 40 minutes. My dear friend, this is the entire story. Yeah, but although you may feel that it is a lot, yeah, but what I did today is just only on the surface. Yeah, and if you're interested, we can, you know, can go further. And maybe Tuan Sharif, after I retire, kita boleh kerjasama.
Betul. Collaborate.
We collaborate among us. Yeah. I mean, to let's go, because my personal vision or mission is to share this idea with as many people as possible, especially the youth. Because I believe nowadays, yeah, the youth really need this, especially to deal with the VUCA world. Yeah. So last but not least from me, I think I need to sing this song. Because this song basically is for Tuan Sharif for sempena birthday dia, yeah. But again, the song basically is also for us. We are the leaders, yeah. So allow me to just to read through the so-called the lyrics of this song. Because this song, the lyric of this song, banyak sangat rapatnya, sangat berkaitan rapat dengan the meaning of being a leader. So there's a story in this song that relate to the so-called the meaning to be a leader. Okay, let me just go quickly before we listen to the song. Yeah, the song title, How Does a Moment Last Forever? What you mean by moment last forever? How our leadership lasts forever? That's what I meant. Yeah. So stated here, how does a moment last forever? How can a story never die? It is love we must hold on to. Never easy, but we try. In other words, in order for to achieve your goal, yeah, your story is your goal, yeah. So your love, basically, your how good at you are applying future engaged deliver in your story. That's what you meant by the first paragraph, yeah. And continue. Sometimes our happiness is captured. That's life, ups and downs, as I mentioned earlier, yeah. Somehow our time and place stand still. Sometimes we don't make any improvement and we just get so bored, yeah, so down, yeah. But love, life on inside out, our hearts and always will. But if we remember FED, and life is so temporary, life is so short, yeah, there's no time for us to get bored. That's what you meant by the second paragraph. Continue by minutes turn to hours, days to years, and gone. That's life, yeah. But when all else has been forgotten, still our song lives on. What you meant by this, if we do good to this world, if we lead good in this world, people will remember our leadership. People will see that Tuan Sharif is a good model for being a leader, something like that. Yeah. And maybe some moments weren't so perfect. Maybe some memories not so sweet. But we have to know some bad times or our lives are incomplete because we learn through mistake. Being a leader, never ever takut sama mistake. We must face the so-called mistake and do something about it. That's how we develop our leadership. Yeah. Okay, from there, then when the shadows overtake us, just when we feel all hope is gone, we'll hear our song and know once more our love lives on. That's how we should subscribe to FED. That's how you subscribe to leadership. How does a moment last forever? How does our happiness endure? Through the darkest of our troubles, love is beauty, love is pure. In other words, in order for us to go through whatever challenge in this life, especially when we're leading something, remember, stick to the basic, future, engage, deliver. It will create beauty. It will create pure in our leadership. Love pays no mind to desolation. It flows like a river through the soul, protects, proceeds, and perseveres, and makes us whole. My dear friends, if we really understand leadership from FED perspective, we develop each area of this FED that makes us whole as a leader. And last but not least, minutes turn to hours, days to years, then gone. But when all else has been forgotten, still our song lives on. How does a moment last forever when our song lives on? I hope, my dear friend, let's work out on our leadership. And by doing so, we hope that, we can leave a good leadership legacy to the people that we live. So, my dear friend, without further much ado, let's listen to this song. Listen the song with your emotional, not listen the song only with your logics. Yeah, let's feel the so-called leadership drive through, flow through us. Okay, jom kita dengar sama-sama. How does a moment last forever? Simple, the song for all leaders, all of us here.
A It is love we must hold on to. Never easy, but we try. Sometimes our happiness is captured. Somehow a time and place then stay. Love lives on inside our hearts and always will. Minutes turn to hours, days to years then gone. But when all else has been forgotten, still our song lives on. Maybe some moments weren't so perfect, maybe some memories not so sweet, but we have to know some bad times, or our lives are incomplete. Then when the shadows overtake us, just when we feel all hope is gone, our song and no one's more. A love lives on. Our happiness endure through the darkest of our troubles. Love is beauty, love is pure. Love brings no mind to desolation. It flows like a river through the soul. Protects, precedes, and perseveres, and makes us whole.
Ini gambar bila ni tuan? Masa muda.
Tak, dua tahun lepas.
Dua tahun lepas?
Yes.
Oh.
Okay, my dear friend. That's all folks. Merry Melodies. Sampai ingat kartun ni, ingatlah. And thank you again, my dear. I'm sorry on any wrong words that I use. Yeah. So I thank you for, you know, for giving me this opportunity. And Selam Hari Raya. Maaf Zahir Batin. Over back to you, Tuan Sharif. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, terima kasih banyak. Thank you very much, Tuan Mior, for this very, very fruitful sharing session. You know, when I saw this, presentation, it is more than what we expected, lah. Actually, it's not basic. It's not basic. It's not 101. But this is leadership from a different perspective. Yeah. Thank you, Tuan Mior, for your lovely sharing session. And
my
thank
pleasure.
You all for being very patient. I expected 20. Roughly, we have about just now maximum 21. Now, ada a few drop-ups because of other chores and then the battery problem. And remember, the next session will be tentatively on the 14th. The title is how to create a strategic business plan. And it will be by your birthday boy lah. Okay, macam usual lah, Saturday 11 to 12:30 p.m. Then before we end the session, can we have a group photo? Boleh tak? Can everybody please put on your switch on your video? Kalau you have your tudung sideways, you know, you can repair it now. Siapa yang tak sikat macam Cik Zul tadi? Dah sikat nampaknya. Okay, can we have Raymond, Azlin, Dr. Khairuddin? Dr. Khairuddin is a champion for trainer punya ni ya, group ya. Okay. And Haji Jamal, Dr. Sufi. We have a lot of doctors here. I think three doctors. Eh? Dr. Sufi, Dr. Jinsia. What happened to Jinsia ada? Tapi gelap eh, doktor. Okay. Yang lain tak boleh buka eh? Tak apa. Can we put on a good, you know, posture before I take the photo? You nak freestyle pun tak apa. No problem. Ready? One, two, three.
Video.
Okay, one more time. One more time. Kali ni different posture, better sikit. Nak buat funny pun tak apa. Ready? Saya tak boleh eh, nak buat ni tapi aku boleh sengitkan lah. Freestyle. Pasal apa? Tangan pegang ni. Dua. Mouse dengan apa? Ready? One, two, three. Okay. I will pass the photo dalam group ni ya. Eh. For those who have not become a group member of this webinar session, please do. Please WhatsApp me. My number is 019-662-177. It's inside the chat group so that you will not miss for any future session. All right. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat berbuka puasa and selamat Hari Raya dan maaf zahir batin. Okay, bye-bye. I will end the session now, yeah?
Thank you.
Okay, everyone. Enjoy the holiday.
Enjoy your
thank
holiday.
You. Thank you very much.
Jaga jarak, jaga SOP, ya? Yeah?
Thank you.
Make sure everybody negative.
Selamat Hari Raya.
Selamat Hari Raya, Mahir Batin.
Mahir Batin.